I'm Jeff Alldredge, and I am the patriarch, head of the house, and master ruler of this family.
He's not a dictator as long as we do what he tells us.
We're the Alldredges, and truth be told, Jeff isn't the only ruler of the house.
You guys need me to find that little garden tool or garden shovel?
One of the pros of polygamy, from the man's perspective, is that you get to share your love and your life with more than one beautiful woman. And we're looking forward to adding another wife to this family.
Well, she'll just give them each a tiny little bit. This should be enough, and then it will rain later.
This last year's been really tough on our family. We spent a long time courting a woman named Melina.
We really thought that Melina had the potential to be our new sister wife, but when the time came to meet her, she got cold feet, stood us up at the airport, and that was really hard for all of us.
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, honey.
Eventually, Melina did make the effort to come out and see us in person, but we quickly discovered that it was not the right fit for all of us.
She says that because I couldn't open up to her, that's the reason why she couldn't come, and that's the reason why she's nervous. Why come?
In the middle of dealing with all of the heartbreak, we got more bad news. Vanessa, who we thought was 12 weeks pregnant, was actually having a molar pregnancy, which is a tumor that tricks your body into thinking that it's pregnant.
And there's not a baby in it that I can tell. I'm sorry.
I was devastated.
Seems like everything's going a little bit wrong.
While I wasn't pregnant with an actual child, it did feel like I was losing my baby. It really was a traumatizing experience for all of us.
Okay, stay out of Daniel's way so that he doesn't run over you guys.
Serenity, no!
After having gone through so much, we just moved to Hot Springs, South Dakota this last winter because the laws are pretty harsh in Utah towards our lifestyle. And so it was time to leave the state.
Good job!
We're all very happy to be here in South Dakota on our new ranch. For we can enjoy life and our religious beliefs without fearing for our freedom.
I love it because we're not too far from town, but it feels like we are.
Right now, we're living in a smaller apartment that's on the property that currently has 4 bedrooms. Sharice and I have our own rooms. Our kids share the other 2 rooms. Jeff alternates between my room or Sharice's room. But we're currently in the process of fixing up a big lodge that is unfinished that's on the property.
So this is our dream, a place to be together.
When it's done, it will be plenty big enough to house all of us and more.
Sharice, I believe this is the room you would like.
Our plan is that every sister wife will essentially have her own wing. And that'll kind of provide for some privacy.
Yeah, we'll share the main areas of the house, but each wife will have their own individual, like, bedroom wing.
Why don't you guys tell me that's what you wanted all this time?
How come you haven't been listening to us all this time? That's what I want to know.
Teresa and I have talked, and this is probably where I would put my rooms. Put the master bedroom in here, maybe 1 or 2 other rooms for my kids.
Yeah, like your own little apartment. This will be your space that you can do whatever you want with.
We have lots of work to do. But we're just ready. Ready to bring in a new family member.
Okay, let's stand it up right here until Dad gets the ladder up there.
Although the last few months have been very challenging, we're actually all in very good spirits because we have some great news. We are officially courting another potential sister wife named Jennifer. We met Jennifer online and she lives up by Niagara Falls. She's 30 years old. She's a really fun and spunky person with a great personality.
Jennifer shares a little bit of common history as far as her childhood from a polygamous family. But beyond that, she's lived a different life than we are used to. It's not typically the person that we are drawn to.
Okay, keep the kids out from underneath in case I accidentally drop the sign or something or myself.
Jennifer's the kind of woman who is very adventuresome. She's done a lot of things. She's kind of a biker, or has been a biker. She's got this little bullet bike that she speeds around on. And she's just like this little firecracker woman. I think if that can be tempered, at least to our family's goals.
Yeah, you know, you point that energy in the right direction and it can go far.
You know, but it can also be a divisive thing if it's unchecked and left wild. Then I don't know how good a fit it'll be for our family. But that's why we're courting.
That looks so pretty. I love it.
We haven't met Jennifer in person yet, but we have been talking for a while now. Phone calls, video messaging. We're very serious about her. She's very serious about us.
And we're really excited to see where this goes.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
Jennifer might be wife number three for the Alldredges.
Okay, we're about to.
Hey there, Jennifer.
How are ya?
We're doing good. Sebastian says hi.
Hi.
There's Dalinar. And there's Serenity. Can you say hi?
Even though there's a possibility Jennifer might not be ready to meet in person, I think it's time that we ask her and find out.
Am I gonna move his fingers up behind your head?
You know, the ladies and I have been chatting a lot about it, and we've had a chance to get to know you and have really enjoyed talking over these last few months. And we were hoping to find a time and a place where maybe we could you know, meet with you. How would you feel about that?
Yeah, that would be great.
Cool.
Finally to meet you guys in person versus over a computer.
Yeah.
That's right.
I'm super excited. I think it's been a long time coming and I can't wait.
It has been.
It has.
I'm super excited that Jennifer said that she'd like for us to come visit.
That is exciting.
Yeah. It's like, okay, this is getting real.
Yeah. Hey, Jennifer, we'll see what we can come up with as far as maybe a plan or a time, and we'll see if we can't come visit you.
All right. Sounds great.
It's good to talk with you.
Yes.
Can you say bye-bye,
yes,
kids?
Bye-bye, kids.
No. Can you say bye-bye, Jennifer?
Bye-bye, Jennifer. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Meeting Jennifer is a really big step because right now we kind of have this relationship that's kind of just stable. Once we meet her, it's going to go one of two ways. It's either going to go towards marriage or towards a breakup. And so that's kind of intimidating, but I think we're ready to take the risk, go and see.